just head towards the market opening now. Looks like after yesterday's very strong run, today we could build on to our gains. 18,300 is something that the market is looking to conquer. Of course, we have a lot of participation, you know, coming in from some of these names. M&M is your top mover right now. There's Britannia, Divi's Labs, Bajaj Auto, Aisha Motors. So today looks like it could be, you know, all boats being taken up by the wave sort of a situation. On the downside, UPL is sulking a tad bit, but nothing alarming. BPCL, HCL Tech are a couple of other stocks that are trending in the red. Of course, a lot of numbers as well to analyze. So we'll take that forward in just a bit. Here is the first tick on the index, consolidating after its gains from yesterday. The Nifty up about 30-odd points. The Bank Nifty up 120 points, so playing a bit of catch-up over there. The advance decline ratio is solid at about 1390 stocks on the advancing side. In terms of individual names, let's just take a look at the stocks that are charging ahead. FMCG and consumption has really been, you know, a front and center in terms of gains for the market. Today as well, Titan, Britannia are up in the green. A couple of other names from the auto space, M&M, Maruti, Bajaj Auto, Aisha Motors, Tata Motors, all these stocks are looking pretty good. Adani Enterprises, your top Nifty gainer, HDFC Life is doing pretty well. On the downside, UPL is down about 1.5%. Sonal was telling us that there are a lot of bears in the market post the numbers, the weakness that we've seen in the earnings. Sun Pharma, that Mohali issue continues to keep a lid on the stock gains. HCL Tech, Bajaj Finance, Hindalco and BPCL are a couple of other names that are not looking that great this morning. But now the market is actually building on to its gains. So this is turning out to be a pretty decent opening. The Nifty is now above the 18,300 mark. Remember, we're just within kissing distance of that, you know, all-time highs on the market. I think less than about 3.5% away from all-time highs. The Bank Nifty is just now about 2% away from all-time highs, maybe 1.5%. So we're virtually at those highs and looking pretty good for the market.
Well, that's right. The Nifty Financial Services Index as well, that's going to swing trade in the second half today because it has the weekly expiry. That's almost at a 52-week high. So keep an eye out on that one. It's only around 130 points away from there. So let's see whether or not that gets there. But stocks that are in focus. Kansai Nerolac, margin expansion bonus issue. This market likes it. Up closer on 3%. Bidla Soft, well, the numbers look pretty good, stripped of any kind of one-offs. And they're talking about expanding margins to around 15 to around 16% in the second half of year. And they want to hit 16% in quarter four. For the time being, the street lacks those set of numbers. Carbonendum Universal, those margin expansions is something that the street has taken with both hands. So that as well was up closer around 3.5%. It's in fact now up closer around 6%. So that's building on the gains. MGL, one of the top gainers in the F&O pack. Sonal told us that the margins at 7-quarter highs is something that the street likes. So that as well up closer around 6%. VIP, the street was anticipating a strong set of numbers given the kind of unlock of the travel revenge travel that we have seen. And VIP Industries as well already has run up a goodish bit. But for starters, it's up closer to 100%. Andhra Papers, the numbers look quite good. So that, I think, as well, had a bit of a green tick. Easy Planners, they're looking at inorganic opportunities. They're also looking at a potential foray into the general insurance space. So, you know, we'll have Easy Trip Planners as well that comes up for you in the screen. On the flip side, your Pidilite. There was a volumes miss out there. High quality name, but margin as well as volume miss. And that's why that stock is down closer to 100%. And Aarti Industries, a bit of a degrowth on the top line. There was some margin compression as well. So I think the initial tick on that one was down 3%. It's now down closer to 2.5%. And Indostar, last couple of days, volumes have been quite high. And the stock has moved quite well. Two sessions, stock up more than 10%. Indostar is the one we're talking about. Should come up for you on the screen at some point in time. Prashant.
I mean, it's a decent start, Nigel, right? I mean, after yesterday's move, this is not a bad start to have in terms of the open. Let's have the Nifty up. We're up 40 points. This is better than what the SGX was indicative of. And I think a lot of names that you mentioned are, summarize what's happening with regards to result reactions, etc. Pretty neatly. So the big mover, of course, is you guys pointed out, is MGL with a 6% plus pop. You know, the next is Manappuram, which is up 3%. So yesterday's 3, today's 3. Slowly it's inching up. Birla Soft, we mentioned, is up 3. Kansai is up 8. You know, so that's IGL is up about 3% or so as well. Carborundum Universal, and Rima had highlighted the numbers earlier, 5% on that one, and so on and so forth. Greaves Cotton is up about 2.6%. KEI Industries is up 2. KEC had a pretty large move yesterday. KEC is up 3.5% as well. So many from the broader market, which are actually looking pretty good on the back of strong volumes as well. Anything on the downside? I mean, the Adani Total, Adani Transmission, those stocks were lower under pressure yesterday. At least at start, Adani Transmission is down 5%. It's a top volume traded name as well. And at number two position is UPL. I was saying this earlier, UPL numbers, I mean, do leave a fair bit to be desired. Stocks down about 2%. Pidilite is neither here nor there. It's down 1%. That's it. Zomato is down 1%. There was news yesterday that, you know, Invesco has cut their estimate of Swiggy's valuation for the second time this year. And Zomato, I don't know if that's the impact, but it's down about 1%. Small one. Oracle Financial Services is the other one, which is coming up with a 6% cut.
That's an interim dividend.
Interim.
Yeah. Okay. Adjusted, it's flat.
Okay. APAR Industries is down about 3%, and Adani Total Gas is another one, which is down about 1.5% as well. Aarti Industries, again, something we were talking about earlier, numbers are not all that great, 1.6% lower. We have the management join us in just a bit from now. 40 points still on the Nifty. We are at 18,300 plus on the index.